Hi, Remi.
Hello there.
So what is it that first got you into investing?
The first thing that got me into investing is this idea of long term and actually working with people to build their long term goals. And I was quite surprised that investing is associated with that. I must be brutally honest. When I was graduating at uni and I met a few people and they said, no, actually, if you have a goal, if you have a drive, actually investing is inextricably linked to that. And that's what investing.
And you mentioned there that you were surprised about that link. Do you think that's something that is typical of many women, that kind of lack of knowledge, that lack of introduction that sort of holds them back from making personal investments themselves?
Absolutely. I think that the confidence may be something. I think as women, we're very good in terms of analysing, in terms of researching, in terms of making decisions, but not necessarily linking that to investing. But actually, that investing is, you know, requires our skills. Exactly what we're good at, multitasking, is excellent for investing. And so I think a lot of women, we lack that confidence in terms of understanding that what we do already is perfect for investing.
Now, I know on your team, you have a number of other women, Johanna, who we've had the opportunity to talk to for this series as well. But would you say that is typical of the city? Because there is a view that it is just men in suits.
Things are changing, I must admit. I've been in the city for about 16, 17 years now, and the last 5 to 6 years has been very different. So when I started, yes, it was just men in suits. Johanna was my first female boss, which was about 15 years ago. And ever since then, we have seen more and more women join the city with confidence and are very happy with their career here.
And then thinking about retail investors, everyday investors and not professional investors, what do you think women should know, and indeed all investors starting out, to really make sure that first step is a successful one?
The most important thing is to focus on what you enjoy. It must be enjoyable. I think investing shouldn't be something that makes you feel uncomfortable. There is so much opportunity. You can invest in equities and fixed income across a variety of markets. If you enjoy it, you will get better at it. That's the most important thing. Trying to identify things that interest you.
And that's very true, because there's always a human, there's always an everyday element to investing. I was always surprised, for example, when there was a weather event in the US, how that could then affect stock markets all over the world.
Exactly. I tend to find that people, there's always, as you mentioned, a human effect, an association with a company that you may like their goods and services. That should encourage you to invest, be a part of their future. That's a good way to start.
And then looking to the future, you say there has already been quite a lot of change in the city, a positive change in terms of diversity around the table. What do you see the future of the city being? Hopefully a continuation of the same.
A continuation of the same. A continuation of this collaboration between a variety of people and being very interested in their views, their background, their knowledge, and what they have to bring to the table. I think this makes us better investors, and it enables us to actually make a difference in terms of the world. I mentioned that investment, we need to think about linking it to the long term. We also need to link it to the future, the world we want to have, and we can direct our finances and our capital towards that.
And you don't have to make a choice between ethics and profits anymore, do you? I mean, you can do good, as you say, and bring about a better world, but you can also make money while doing it.
Exactly.
Remi, thank you very much.
Thank you so much for your time today.